Among the decisions Vermont voters will make next month, who they want to watch over the state's finances. Today, the two candidates who want the job disagreed on a lot in the first real debate of the fall campaign. News Channel 5 Stuart Ledbetter joins us with details live from our Vermont newsroom tonight. Stuart.
Well, Stephanie, sounds odd to say it, but the state auditor of accounts doesn't have to be an auditor or even an accountant. They have to win an election every other year and then oversee a small staff charged with ensuring integrity in the state's financial statements. This year, two men are battling for the job.
In their first broadcast debate, State Auditor Tom Salmon pressed Democratic challenger Doug Hoffer over Hoffer's qualifications for the job.
I'm not aware that you have any management experience over people or have performed an audit. How do you expect to compensate for this lack of training if elected and experience as a non-auditor, non-accountant, and non-CPA?
Hoffer, a lawyer and fiscal analyst, fired back, noting the contract work he'd done for previous auditors for years.
It's kind of curious you would say I've never done an audit because I've got about six or eight of them on your website.
Those are audits or reviews?
There were compliance audits, performance reviews, a number of things.
And so it went for an hour on Vermont Public Radio.
The legislature adopted a requirement for what's called the Unified Economic Development Budget,
right,
which you did not address in your review.
Taking listeners through the sometimes arcane world of public accounting, Hoffer pledged to put his budget online.
So when I leave, I'd like to be able to say, now they know what we do.
Both agreed it's critical to help the part-time legislature understand where tax dollars really go. Then Salmon suggested turning the two-year auditor's term on its head.
We as a state may find a benefit of having some sort of a 10-year term or some sort of an appointment of an auditor general, and we would look at some of the models first. But again, going to the legislature and look, this office needs to be stabilized.
Hoffer disagreed, saying elections give the state's money watchdog independence. And desire to help.
Tom Salmon thinks Vermont could benefit from better long-term planning that an appointed auditor might provide. Hoffer said later that was an odd and radical proposal, quoting him. And by the way, it would require a change to the state constitution as well. Live in the Vermont newsroom, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.